हेलो हेलो हेलो, वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स. एम आई विजिबल टू ऑल? एम आई ऑडिबल टू ऑल? फ्रॉम वेयर वी आर स्ट्रीमिंग देयर वुड बी अ स्लाइट लैग एंड अ डिले, बट यस, कैन एम आई विजिबल टू ऑल? एम आई ऑडिबल टू ऑल? कैन ऑल ऑफ यू हियर मी? कैन ऑल ऑफ यू सी मी? सो यस, सो जस्ट वन थिंग, आई विल लाइव. यस, जस्ट वन सेकेंड. या हेलो ऑल ऑफ यू, कैन एम आई विजिबल टू ऑल? एम आई ऑडिबल टू ऑल? इज द ऑडियो वीडियो ऑल क्लियर? सो यस, ओके. सो ऑल ऑफ, यस आई कैन हियर. यस, ऑल ऑफ यू कैन सी मी, ऑल ऑफ यू कैन हियर मी. यस, सो कीप द कमेंट्स कमिंग इन, एंड यस, परफेक्टली फाइन. सो जस्ट बिफोर वी बिगिन क्विकली, ऑल ऑफ यू, दिस इज द प्लस सब्सक्रिप्शन. व्हाट ऑल यू गेट? डेली लाइव क्लासेस, स्ट्रक्चर्ड कोर्सेज, लाइव क्विज, अनलिमिटेड एक्सेस. जस्ट कपल ऑफ थिंग, आइकॉनिक सब्सक्रिप्शन, बेस्ट ऑफ बोथ द वर्ल्ड. दर्ज अ प्राइस ड्रॉप ऑल्सो इन द आइकॉनिक सब्सक्रिप्शन. एंड डू नॉट फॉरगेट टू यूज द कोड मेंटर. ओके, नाउ देर आर मोर देन 34,000 MCQs ऑन द क्वेश्चन बैंक अवेलेबल, एंड द प्रोमो कोड टू बी यूज इज MENTOR, मेंटर इज द प्रोमो कोड. ओके, एंड दिस इज अ ग्रेट थिंग. विद 2 month सब्सक्रिप्शन यू आर गेटिंग 12 month सब्सक्रिप्शन यू आर गेटिंग 2 months फ्री कंप्लीटली. सो दिस इज 12+2 ऑफर. एंड वॉट एल्स इज अवेलेबल इज दैट MBBS फाउंडेशन बैचेज हैव स्टार्टेड फॉर सेकेंड ईयर एंड थर्ड ईयर प्रोफेशनल कोर्सेज. लॉट्स ऑफ बैचेस कमिंग अप. दिस इज अ आइकॉनिक सब्सक्रिप्शन. लॉट्स ऑफ प्राइस ड्रॉप इज नाउ अवेलेबल. एंड दिस इज अ वेरी गुड ऑफर दैट विथ 3 month सब्सक्रिप्शन 1 month इज कंप्लीटली फ्री. सो 3 months फ्री विथ 12 month सब्सक्रिप्शन, 2 months फ्री यू आर गेटिंग. विथ 3 month सब्सक्रिप्शन 1 month फ्री यू आर गेटिंग. ओके, एंड यस, एंड 4 year सब्सक्रिप्शन इज ऑल्सो स्टार्टेड फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स. यू ऑल ऑफ यू कैन जॉइन दैट. एंड दिस इज अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सुपर फीचर वेयर इज अ रेज द हैंड एंड ऑन द स्पॉट डाउट कैन बी क्लियर. ओके, सो यू कैन रेज योर हैंड. इट्स लाइक अ लाइव क्लास एंड ऑन द स्पॉट यू कैन आस्क. एंड ड्यूरिंग अवर लाइव क्लासेज, इज ड्यूरिंग अवर प्लस क्लासेज, इफ यू एनरोल एंड ऑन द स्पॉट वी विल बी एबल टू हेल्प यू सॉल्व योर डाउट. सो लाइक योर लाइव क्लासेज, लाइक योर क्लासरूम कोचिंग, कैन आस्क अस योर डाउट. एंड दिस इज अ वेरी नाइस फीचर ऑफ रेज द हैंड विच ऑल ऑफ यू कैन यूज इट. Okay, these are all the upcoming batches of which we are the part of it. So basically you just need to download the Unacademy app, and depending on your requirement, 3 months, 6 months, 12 months subscription you can go for. Do not forget to use the promo code MENTOR. With 3 months you're getting 1 month free, with 12 months you're getting 2 months free. Is understood to all of you without wasting any further time. And the last thing is, just click on this link, come to the Unacademy page and just click on the follow button, so that whenever my next upcoming classes are there, all of you will be able to come to know. You will get notifications about all my free lectures. Okay, so with this, let us start with the first. This is focus for INICT, upcoming INICT, some clinical case based questions we are going to discuss. Some, the voice will be now be better. Hello, hello. Just 1 second, I'll just increase the yeah. So yes, is the voice better now? Audio will be better now. Yes. Okay, so we are going to discuss some clinical case based MCQs, match the column kind of an MCQ, and also other kinds. Yes, so can anybody tell me the first question for the day? I have got patient XYZ, 2 months amenorrhea. She is having 2 months amenorrhea, and on ultrasonography of the uterus, pseudo sac. What is pseudo sac suggestive of? Anybody? Diagnosis. There's a right side adnexial mass. This HCG 1500, 1500 pulse, BP, hemoglobin. What is the most suitable modality? Anybody? A, B, C, D. So first, I would want all of you to tell me about the diagnosis. Anybody? Can anybody quickly tell me about the diagnosis? Somehow I can't see your chats. Just 1 second. Yeah, so can anybody tell me about the diagnosis, please, over here? Yeah, anybody, what is the diagnosis over here? Anybody? Yes, I'm. Yes, so very, very important. What is this pseudo sac inside the uterus? Just one second. Yes. Yes, perfectly correct. B, because we're ectopic. Yes, ectopic. Yes, but I want a better answer. Yes, very good. Now I can see all your chats also. Very good. And I hope everybody was extremely beneficial with our FMG classes. I've got lots of messages that all the students have cleared FMG after listening to the lectures. Okay, so yes, point number one, please understand the HCG is positive. Okay, so HCG is positive. That means there is pregnancy. Is this one point clear to all of you? Yes, HCG is positive. So there is pregnancy. That one thing is clear for all of us. And the important point is that we are also seeing a adnexial mass. So adnexial mass, that mass is what? Okay, there's a right-sided adnexial mass of 2.5 into 3 centimeters. Okay, so there is a 2.5 or 3 centimeter mass. What is this mass? And HCG is positive, levels are 1500. And what is a pseudo sac? Yes, very good, Rajat, and all of you correct. Okay. Yeah, thank you, Pratibha Das. Thank you for have cleared FMG 181. Fabulous, excellent. Okay. Yeah, thank you, Pratibha. You will do very well in NEET PG also with this lectures. Okay. So now, very, very important. Please understand what is a pseudo sac and what is a true gestational sac. The important point difference between the two is that, sir, a true gestational sac. All of you, please pay attention. A true gestational sac will have a well circumcised, properly circular, with a thick echogenic ring around it, which they will teach you in your radiology class also. That is the double decidual sign. Okay, the double decidual sign. So this is a true gestational sac. Okay, true gestational sac, there is a double decidual sign around it. So what is the thing? It is thick-walled, echogenic rim, and properly circular. Compared to this, the pseudo sac is very, very thin. It is a thin and irregular. Okay, it is thin and irregular. This is because of the hormonal changes which take place because of this ectopic pregnancy. So please don't get confused. Basically, yes, it's just a decidual reaction. It is basically a pseudo sac. Pseudo sac is also there. It is also a sign of ectopic, and empty uterus is also a sign of ectopic. So please understand this, that on ultrasonography, when the HCG is positive and you get these two options, either they say pseudo sac is seen or they say uterus is empty. Both will point to the same diagnosis of ectopic pregnancy, because sir, HCG is positive, this uterus empty and pseudo sac can be interchangeably used in your entrance exam. Means either they will say uterus is completely empty or a pseudo sac is seen. I repeat, pseudo sac is a thin walled irregular sac, which is not the actual sac. Okay, so your diagnosis is ectopic pregnancy, and along with this we have to go back and see what else is there. Yes sir, hemoglobin 11, pulse BP 120/80, all perfect. So it is a stable patient with a unruptured ectopic pregnancy. Perfectly correct answer is methotrexate. Okay, laparotomy is done in patients of shock and when there is a ruptured ectopic. Okay, when there is a ruptured ectopic. Is this understood to all of you? So I'm describing all the options. Wait and watch is out of question. In ectopic, you never wait and watch. And laparoscopy may be done when the patient is stable and not fit for methotrexate. And all of us should know what are the criterias for methotrexate. Yes, sir. All this exactly given in the question paper. What condition? Sir, when the pregnancy is less than 4 centimeter. Okay, so look over here. So when the gestational sac is less than 4 centimeter and HCG level less than 5000 and a stable patient, all that patients methotrexate will be done. Okay, a bit of DM 3000, some say 5000, so 5000 acceptable. Dr. DM, can you hear me? Yes, till less than 5000 we can go ahead with HCG, with the ectopic management by methotrexate. Okay, so anybody, and after giving methotrexate, how do I know the treatment is working or not? after giving methotrexate, we have to monitor the HCG levels, and the HCG levels should keep on dropping down. Is this understood to all of you? Okay, so very, very important. This is an extremely important MCQ for the upcoming examination. Okay, please keep this in mind. Okay, here, sir, we have a stable patient, unruptured ectopic, gestational sac less than 4 cm. Answer is methotrexate. Moving ahead with the next MCQ. Yes, all of you. Yes, fetal cardiac activity swarup correct. Preferably should be absent. Preferably should be absent. And yes, Kalim, you are correct. You monitor the HCG. Yes. Now, all of you. Second MCQ for that. Again, a clinical case. 19-year-old unmarried girl. 10 weeks pregnancy for medical termination of pregnancy. What is the best option? A, B, C, D, E. Anybody? We have got a 19-year-old unmarried girl. Okay, they will emphasize the word of unmarried girl. Okay, everybody saying B, C, D, E. Okay, so all of you, please pay attention. Point number one, if the girl is major, as long as the girl is major, she herself can give the consent. And in MTP only, the female consent is required. Okay. Please, is this understood to all of you? If the female says, doctor, I don't want this pregnancy, we can do abortion. So this is not, had there been, when do I inform the police when the girl is less than 18 years? If the girl is less than 18 years, you know, as per the POSCO Act, that is crime. Even with consensual sex, less than 18 years of age is, as per POSCO, is considered as rape. So that has to be informed the police. But still, MTP is not contraindicated. We can go ahead and do MTP. So it's not that we delay the MTP. MTP can be done, but we have to inform the police. So I repeat, when the girl is less than 18 years, two things have to be done. When the female is less than 18, what are the two things we will do for MTP? If the patient of MTP comes to you, she is less than 18 years, then I have to inform the police, and then also the guardian consent will be required. Okay, guardian consent, or if she is not mentally sound, then only the guardian consent. If here the patient is 19-year-old, even though she is unmarried, no problem, she can give the consent. So this ethacridine lactate is a solution for second trimester MTP. Okay, for second trimester MTP, this ethacridine lactate should be used. Okay, and dilatation and curettage is not a method for MTP. Curette should be avoided, because what is the risk, anybody? When we use a curette in MTP, what is the risk? And dilatation and curettage is done for gynec procedures, not for the pregnant lady. The word used is dilatation and evacuation. That is the word. Okay, and curettage should be avoided. And between A and B, yes, the answer is option number B. Yes, very good, because not only perforation, okay, but mainly Asherman syndrome. That's why we avoid curette. Okay, and MVA, manual vacuum aspiration or suction evacuation, also called as dilatation and evacuation. We use the Haga's dilator and a suction cannula. Okay, because she is 10 weeks pregnant. Please understand this, anybody. Mifi meso is still what weeks? Mifepristone misoprostol is a very good method for MTP, but for that the patient should be less than 9 weeks. So had this patient been 6 weeks, 7 weeks, then I would have definitely chosen A as the answer. Yes. Okay, yeah, 7 weeks, 8 weeks were the old criteria, but now up to 9 weeks. Yes, correct. So till 9 weeks we can use it, but here the patient is clearly 10 weeks. So the option is this understood to all of you? Is understood to all of you? So yeah, okay, so we should be very, very clear that, sir, here the patient is 10 weeks pregnant, so Mifi meso will not work. Mifi meso is only up to maximum 9 weeks we can do it. So the answer is MVA and suction evacuation. This ethacridine lactate is for second trimester MTP, and you don't need to inform the police and all that, because she is a 19-year-old girl. Yes. Correct. Moving ahead to the next question. Yes, which of the following produces medical oophorectomy in a patient of endometriosis? Anybody, what is endometriosis condition? Answers: ethinyl ethyl cabergolin, LNG, goserelin. Okay, what is the meaning of medical oophorectomy and endometriosis? Okay, please understand this. In a patient of endometriosis, by the way, all these drugs can be used. No. Okay, so see, tough MCQ. Please understand the question. What is the meaning of medical oophorectomy? Okay, and what is the logic? No, Mahesh, no, beta, no. Yes, right. Okay, yes. So please understand this, that in endometriosis, the lining of the uterus, the endometrium, this is the endometrium, is growing at places outside the uterus. And by medical management, anybody, what is the logic of medical management? So the logic of the medical management, please understand, it's a very difficult MCQ. When I want to do medical management of endometriosis, the logic is to suppress the patient menses or induce amenorrhea in the patient. I want that, yes, very good, Chandra Jyoti, very good. I want that after the surgery or in endometriosis, the patient should not get menses for 5-6 months. So please understand this, ethinyl estradiol, only ethinyl estradiol is never used. Unopposed estrogen should not be used. Levonorgestrel IUD also will induce amenorrhea. This is progesterone induced amenorrhea, which is called as, this, anybody, what is this called as? This is called as pseudo pregnancy regime. Please pay attention, very important MCQ. What is pseudo pregnancy regime, if they ask you, or regimen? Sir, pseudo pregnancy because of sir, in pregnancy there's a lot of progesterone. So LNG IUD, another name is Myrina is another name. And because in pregnancy there's lots of progesterone and LNG IUD again contains progesterone, there is a pseudo pregnancy. Medical oophorectomy means what? Medical oophorectomy means I want to suppress the ovarian function. Because oophorectomy means removing the gonads. The word could used be medical oophorectomy, or also the word could used be medical castration. Do not make a mistake, and that is by giving option number D is the answer. What is this drug, anybody, all of you? What is goserelin? What is this option, goserelin? Goserelin is what, anybody? Yes, anybody? Yes. What is goserelin, all of you? Goserelin, anybody? Goserelin is what kind of a drug? Yes, it is a GnRH analog, and specifically, yes, GnRH agonist. All of you, correct, very good, my students, Peter, Shri Spruha, Chandra, all of you, Abhigda, Santosh, Yadav, all of you, fabulous, yes, okay. So it is a GnRH agonist, and what will the GnRH agonist do? So the GnRH agonist will suppress the HPO axis. It will basically suppress the HPO axis, so it will stop the ovarian function. Yes, final line is, it is a ovarian function, so it will be, we will induce amenorrhea in the patient, but it is by doing a oophorectomy, but we are not surgically removing the ovary, so it is called as medical oophorectomy. So all, remember, all these three mean the same thing. Medical oophorectomy is same as gonadectomy. Gonadectomy is same as castration. Anywhere you use this, you see this word in the question paper, castration. Or yes, oophorectomy or gonadectomy or castration, please mark GnRH analog as the answer, which is goserelin. It could be like buserelin or whatever, naphthalene, all that, okay. So LNG IUD is also used, but it is not the answer because it is a pseudo pregnancy regimen, continuous progesterone. Okay, is it understood? Yes, Neha, correct. It will initially stimulate, but then finally desensitize. Okay, Neha Kumari, initially, because it is an agonist, there is an initial flare, but because of continuous response, yes, there is a de sensitization and down regulation of receptors. Okay, so desensitization and down regulation of receptors. Therefore, GnRH agonists, they actually suppress the ovarian function. So no ovary, so no estrogen, no progesterone, so no menses. Okay, so menses will of the patient will stop. Is understood to all of you? Yes. Yes, and now anybody, we are having a match the column kind of a question. All of you, I want you to answer this match the column and tell me the answer. Here some names are given and here some conditions are given. So anybody, can you please tell me what is this and where it is? Okay, what is MSV? Morrissey smelly wheat, because match the column is very important for the upcoming INICET exam. Okay, INICET exam, match the column likely to come. Whatever we are selecting, very likely. Okay, so sir, Morrissey smelly wheat is a maneuver to deliver the after coming head. In what? After coming head of breech. So with this one MCQ, I am able to discuss four MCQs. Okay, yes. So one is going with C. So 1C, 1C. So this both are wrong. Okay. Now, Mac Roberts maneuver is for what? Mac Robert maneuver is for shoulder dystocia. Perfectly correct. So 2 is F. Yes, perfectly correct. Sir, Collier uterus is a condition which I get in abruption, and that also which abruption? Concealed abruption. Okay. And so 3 is A, and McAfee and Johnson regimen, anybody, is what? McAfee and Johnson regimen is a conservative management in placenta previa. Red dot dot, I don't know. Yeah, okay. So yeah, correct, perfectly correct, placenta previa. So the answer is 4B, and therefore yes, all those who said option number 4 is perfectly correct. Just before I move ahead, please pay attention, what are the other names for the maneuvers which I do for shoulder dystocia? Okay, so shoulder dystocia, one is, remember just these three names, one is Mac Roberts maneuver, second is Rubin's maneuver, and third is Woods maneuver. Please remember, all these names are associated with our shoulder dystocia. And the important point, shoulder dystocia likely to come with for our INICET exam. The likely point is, please remember, important point, never give fundal pressure. Fundal pressure should be, yes, Gaskin is also correct, never give fundal pressure in a patient of shoulder dystocia. Why? Because the shoulder is stuck behind the pubic symphysis. This is the pubic symphysis, this is the shoulder. When I will give fundal pressure, the shoulder will further hit the pubic symphysis and the condition will worsen. Yes, what we are supposed to give is, because I want the shoulder to come down. So perfectly correct. Yes, Mayank, never give fundal pressure, and Chandra Jyoti correct, suprapubic pressure. You will remember me on the day of the exam. Okay, suprapubic pressure is what we give. Yes or no, suprapubic pressure is what we give. Okay, is it understood to all of you? Yes. Okay, and those who have said yes, you can put that in the, yeah, Dr. Pratibha Das, but very good, put that in the dedications also on the page. Okay, yeah, great, congratulations. Okay, yes, so suprapubic pressure is what we give in a patient of short. We'll quickly have got time for, okay, so never give fundal pressure, and all these names are associated with a patient of shoulder dystocia. There's one more name, the last is Zavellani's maneuver. Okay, Zavellani is also a name with a shoulder dystocia associated. Okay, so all these four maneuvers names you please keep in mind. Anything which come, you mark that with shoulder dystocia only. Okay, moving ahead. Yes, anybody, this is again yes, before season. Okay, one more clinical based MCQ. Infertility is there, and there is a dyspareunia and dysmenorrhea. So what is the done PV examination? Uterus retroverted, restricted motility. Uterus has become more, and laparoscopy findings, what will I get if I do laparoscopy? 1, 2, 3, 4, anybody? Okay, Will I get a subserosal fibroid, Asherman syndrome, chocolate cyst, any of the above? Okay, so what is this? Is point number one, that's a normally the uterus bladder is over here. This is the bladder, the uterus is antiverted. Uterus is antiverted normally, but because of the adhesions in the pouch of Douglas, the uterus will become retroverted. So red is normal. I'll draw it with another color. Yes, the uterus will become retroverted. Uterus has gone backwards, and because of this adhesions, so remember the classical PV finding is a fixed retroverted uterus. Fixed matlab ke there is restrict the side to side mobility. Okay, so when I move normally cervix from side to side, the uterus is freely mobile. That is not possible for me to do. So it's a fixed retroverted uterus, indicating lots of adhesions. And perfectly correct, all of you. This is the classical DID. Yes or no? Dance India dance. Okay, that is the mnemonic. Yes, that's the dance India dance. Is what? Dysmenorrhea, painful periods, infertility, and dyspareunia, painful sex. So this is your diagnosis of perfectly correct endometriosis. And in endometriosis, one more MCQ, laparoscopy is the investigation of choice. Okay, so Asherman syndrome is intrauterine adhesions. We can't see it with laparoscope. What will be required to see Asherman syndrome? Sir, Asherman syndrome mein to intrauterine adhesions hota hai. So I have to use a hysteroscopy to see it. Yes or no? Yes. If I put a laparoscope, then the outside is all normal. Perfectly correct. So ye Asherman syndrome nahi dikhega. Fibroid, a subserosal fibroid should not cause, which is outside the cavity, should not cause this dyspareunia, infertility, dysmenorrhea, and it will not cause retroverted uterus. So the answer is this, because the classical finding is chocolate cyst and adhesions in the pouch of Douglas. Whenever there is endometriosis, what do we see? This is the uterus, and we will see inside the ovary, we see a, yes, chocolate cyst. Perfectly correct. Yes, so we see a chocolate cyst, we see a chocolate cyst, we see a chocolate color, brownish material, that is a chocolate cyst, and all the adhesions you get in the pouch of Douglas along with blue color, red color, all the lesions what we get. Okay, so this is your diagnosis of endometriosis in a fixed retroverted uterus we will get. Okay, yes, and the last question for, yes, powder burn spot mashup, yes, anybody, where, what is this instrument? The last question, so one MCQ for them, and what is, where do you use this instrument? Is it used for tubal ligation to hold the uterine angles analysis? Is it for DINC, MTP, all of the above? Okay, so what is this instrument? All of you, please pay attention, careful attention. This is a triangle tip. Okay, whenever you see a triangle jaisa part like this, oh yes, perfectly correct, all of you, this is a green Armitage. Green Armitage forceps is there, and green Armitage forceps is to hold the angle of the uterus and angles in LSCS surgery. For tubal ligation, which instrument I use? So tubal ligation, I'll just say, okay, tubal ligation. Yes, tubal ligation, we use a Babcock's forceps. Tubal ligation, I use a Babcock's forceps, correct? And DNC, of course, I use a curette and all that stuff. So all of the above is not the answer, okay? So just by the way, remember this, it was a Vivian Bartley Green Armitage, and he had used this for making this gynecologist, and during the World War time, and he has made this instrument. So basically what you do is that if this is the cut edge of the uterus. Okay, you have cut the uterus during cesarean section, so all this angle is likely to be bleeding. Okay, so we put this forceps, like this. Okay, like this the instrument is applied over here. Okay, like this the instrument will be there. Okay, so you hold this instrument like this. Okay, is it understood to all of you? Similarly, the instrument is hold like, so the basic function of this, it is a hemostatic, and then you start tying a knot. You have to put a knot around here and then you release it, and then you keep on suturing. Okay, so basically it is to hold the uterus edges and angles in LSCS, and along with, if this can be used, or even Allis forceps can be used for the same purpose, please keep in mind. Okay, Allis forceps can also be used for the same purpose. Okay, Allis forceps can also be used for the same purpose. Okay, tubal ligation, Babcock's forceps is the atraumatic forceps. Is understood to all of you? Okay, yes. So this was all about the MCQs today. And the last thing, all of you, kindly do not forget to use the mentor code to subscribe as per your requirement of 3 months, 6 months, 12 months subscription. You can take with 3 months, 1 month is free, with 12 months, 2 months is free. And one more, yes, beta, next plus class will be coming, beta. Prithviraj, that plus classes are coming up in the month of this month ending, because right now the current recordings are going on. And there's one more YouTube session is there, okay, on Friday. Okay, that is the day after tomorrow. Today is Wednesday. Friday, all of you, I want all of you to join again on Friday for one more YouTube session. Okay, we have got a one more YouTube session on Friday, which all of you can come and attend. Okay, so just I will give you the upcoming, currently the recordings are going on, so that all of you can get my complete set of recordings on the platform. Friday, okay, this Friday only, exactly after one day, 7th, so 9th, okay, Friday 9th July, 5:30 p.m. on YouTube. Okay, on YouTube we meet for a half an hour MCQ discussion class, where like this clinical case and all that. And the plus classes are in this month, is at the end of this month, beta. Last 3-4 days, Prithviraj, is the plus classes. Okay, okay, so this is where this is there. And Friday 9th of July, I want all of you to join on the YouTube. Okay, and although I'm very happy that all of you clear, many of you, almost all my students cleared the FMG examination, that's what we have received. Okay, but a special classes also, Dr. Shweta, Dr. Special classes will also be coming up. Almost 4 hour special classes I will be taking on the platform. Okay, beta, Shweta Kumari. So special classes will also be starting very soon. Special classes, 4 hours will be happening in this month itself. Okay, in the month of July. So that is why I told all of you, can just go and click on this notification, so that all the special classes, whenever we are having, you will get the notification. So just go to the page of my Dr. Puneet Bhojani and click on the follow button. Okay, Shweta. So special classes dates are not yet revealed now, not yet decided, but July month, definitely 4 hours. So 4 special classes I will be taking in the month of July. Okay, so special class also coming up 9th of July, our YouTube session also coming up, and plus class is also coming up for the month. Okay, so I wish all of you best of luck for your upcoming entrance examination, INICET, which is there in this month, and see you soon for all the upcoming classes. So see all of you on the Friday for another YouTube session. Bye bye, best of luck, and thank you very much. Thank you for joining in today. I hope it was a very informative session. We have discussed clinical case also, image also, and match the column also. All the possible MCQs, a kind of MCQs for INICET, I have tried to cover. Thank you.